fluids and circulation. Body fluids and circulation. Okay. And circulation. Body fluids and circulation. We are doing this question from the AIPMT and also from the NEET exam. So now we'll start this. Okay. We'll start now. Questions are there. So I think students, last time we have done any question from the circulation, any question? Hello, students. Students, hello. Hello.
Hello, sir.
Have you done any question from circulation? Multiple choice question, MCQ, have you done? No. Okay, so we will be doing this now, MCQ question, okay? So number one is here. Okay. Question number one, we will write here. Okay. Okay, question here, write down there. Doctors use. Okay. Stethoscope. Doctor use stethoscope to hear the sound produced. During each cardiac cycle. Okay, then the second sound is heard when number A we go to all AV valves open up. AV valves open up. Number B is here. Okay. Ventricular wall vibrate. Number C now. Okay. Semilunar valve closes down. Closes down after the blood flow into the vessel.
Blood flows into vessels from ventricles.
Okay, number D now. The AV nodes receives signal from SA node. Okay. AV node receives signals from SA node, right? So, okay, heart has got the two types of sound, you know. This is a question here. You see, doctors use stethoscope. No, okay, stethoscope to hear the sound of produced during each of the cardiac cycle. Okay, each cardiac cycle. The sound produced during each cardiac cycle. Okay, the second sound is here when AV valves open up, ventricular wall vibrate, semilunar valve closes down after the blood flows into vessels from ventricles. AV node receives signal from SA node. Okay. AV node receives signal from SA node. Now, Now here, we can go to the, now, what will be the answer here? What will be the exact answer here? Yeah. Now, you see that here. Okay. Now, if I look at the heart here, this is the human heart. Okay. Human heart here. All right now. This is the human heart. Okay. So there are the two types of sound here. One is called as the lap sound. One is called as dub sound. Okay, two types of sounds are there: lap sound and the dub sound. And these are the atria: right atria, left atria, right ventricle, left ventricle. Okay. So here, these are the valves, and this is the pulmonary artery, and this is the pulmonary artery here. No? Pulmonary artery, and here we have the semilunar valve, no? Semilunar valve, and here also the aorta. Aorta also, this is the aorta, no? Aorta, this is the pulmonary artery going here, and the semilunar valve, and this is the aorta, and this is semilunar valve. Okay, so now we have the two sound of the heart. Now, lap-dub sound. Now, okay. Now, the outlet and inlet of the ventricle determine the heart sound. Outlet of the ventricle and inlet of the ventricle determine the heart sound. So here, okay, the heart beat begins. Heartbeat begins atria contract. Okay, atria contract, forcing the blood into ventricle. Then the atria contract, the blood will enter into ventricle, and then heart sound begins. Okay, now when the atria relaxes, right atria and the left atria relaxes. So here is the tricuspid valve, and here is the bicuspid valve. No. Here is the tricuspid valve, and here is the bicuspid valve. Okay, bicuspid valve is there. So when the atria relaxes, okay, tricuspid and bicuspid valve closes. These two valve, no, tricuspid valve and bicuspid valve, they will close when the atria. Atria relax. So when the two atria relax, okay, right atria and the left atria relax, the tricuspid valve and bicuspid valve will close this. And then we hear the first heart sound that is called the lap sound. Lap sound. Okay, then we have dub sound also. Lap sound is the first heart sound, and the dub sound is the second heart sound. So when the second heart sound, we will see the second heart sound. Okay, we will see that ventricle will contract now. Right ventricle and left ventricle will contract. Okay, if ventricle will contract, then the blood from the right ventricle and left ventricle will pump. From right ventricle, blood will pump into the pulmonary artery through the semilunar valve. And similarly, from the left ventricle, blood will be pumped to the atria. Blood will be pumped into aorta. From left ventricle, blood will be pumped into aorta. Okay. So, here what happened there? Okay, aorta. Now, when the ventricle relaxes, when the two ventricle relaxes, the semilunar valve closes. Seminal valve at the pulmonary artery and seminal valve at the aorta closes when the ventricle relax. And we get the second heart sound, a dub sound. So the answer will be, I told you when the seminal valve closes, okay, then what happened there? The ventricle relax and the second heart sound or the dub sound we can hear. So here answer will be seminal valve closes down after the blood flows into the vessel from the ventricle. When the blood will flow into the pulmonary artery and the aorta, the ventricle will relax and seminal valve will close this and we get the second heart sound or dub sound. So answer will be number C. Answer will be number C, okay? Answer will be number C. This is a very, very important question there. Answer will be number C. Okay, this is a very simple question. Okay, then we go to next question now. Okay. We go to next question now here. Okay. Okay, so now your next question is there. Okay. Figure, Krishna. Figure soon. Okay, now we go to figure shows okay, schematic plan of blood circulation. Blood circulation in human. Okay, with level A to D. Okay, A and D. Identify the correct level. Identify the correct level with the given function. Given function. So now here we can go to the diagram. I'll draw the diagram here. Okay, now find out that so the options are there. E. Pulmonary vein. Pulmonary vein, okay, taking impure blood. Pulmonary vein taking impure blood from body parts
Arm body parts. Okay. Now CO2 is equal to 60 millimeter of mercury.
Question number one, 60 millimeter of mercury. Okay. Can I write here? No? Okay. Number B, we can say that. Number B, can you get?
Okay, B, pulmonary artery taking blood from the heart to the lungs. Pulmonary artery taking blood. From heart to lungs. Okay. CO2 is
heart to lungs and heart to lungs.
So pulmonary artery taking blood from heart to lungs and PO2, partial pressure of oxygen, PO2 is equal to 90 millimeter of mercury, 90 mm of Hg. Okay, 90 mm of Hg. Now, I'll go to number C now. Number C. Okay, Venakeva. Vena cava taking blood from body parts to the right ventricle. Number D. And PCO2 will be 45 millimeter of mercury. PCO2 will be 45 millimeter of mercury. Number D now. D. Okay. A, B, C, D. No? D. Okay. Dorsal aorta taking blood from heart to the body. Dorsal aorta taking blood from heart to body, dorsal aorta taking blood from heart to body. Okay, from heart to body, then okay, heart to body, PO2 is equal to body parts, from body, heart to body parts, and PO2 is equal to 95 millimeters. PO2 is equal to 95 millimeter of mercury. Okay, these are the four options you got here. This is the schematic diagram of the circulation of the blood. Okay, blood circulation in human. Label A, B, C, D. A is the pulmonary vein taking in pure blood from the body parts, and partial pressure of oxygen will be 60 millimeter of mercury. Second one, C, vena cava. B will be the pulmonary artery taking blood from heart to lungs, and the partial pressure of oxygen is here 90 millimeter of Hg, 90 mm of Hg. Okay, then C is our vena cava taking blood from the body parts to the right auricle, and the PCO2 is equal to 45 millimeter of mercury, and then D will be dorsal aorta taking blood from her to the body parts. Dorsal aorta taking blood from her to the body parts. And PO2 is equal to 95 millimeter of the mercury. Okay. So these are the four options. So which one is the correct option? In class 11 book, is this
answer is given in the diagrammatically.
So here, when the partial pressure will go to 45 millimeter of the mercury, okay, 45 millimeter of the mercury, then vena cava, they take the blood from the body parts to the right auricle. Vena cava take the blood from the body parts to the right auricle. No, like this we have done last time here. Okay, suppose I draw here. Okay, here now.
See, the flow of the blood will be due to difference in the partial pressure in the heart.
So here I have drawn this now. Last time I have drawn here. These are the inferior vena cava and the superior vena cava. These inferior and superior vena cava, they bring the blood. These are called as the vena cava. Okay, they will bring the blood from the body parts into the right auricle. Into right auricle, okay, right ventricle, left ventricle. So they bring the blood into right auricle, and this flow of the blood will brought about when the partial pressure of the carbon dioxide in the vena cava is 45 millimeter of the mercury. Okay, how much here? It is, this will be the 45 millimeter of the mercury, right? So we take the answer. We take the answer. Okay. We take the answer now. Okay, now the we take the answer number. We take the answer number C. Okay, answer number C is correct answer. We take, this is the correct answer number C. Okay, C vena cava 45 ml, dorsal aorta 95 ml. Okay. 95 millimeter mercury. Dorsal aorta taking blood from, okay, taking blood from heart to body parts. Okay, PO2 is equal to 95 millimeter of the mercury. Okay. And after that, we go to the next question now. After that, we'll be going to the next question now. Okay. You finished, student? All have you finished, all of you students? Hello, you finished?
You students, have you finished? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Hello. Now, after that, we'll go to the next question now. Okay, the diagram given here, okay, is the standard ECG. ECG is the standard ECG of a normal person. Normal person. Standard ECG of a normal person, right? So here, the P wave represents the, okay, the P wave. The P wave represents the, okay, so just write like this. Q R S T. Okay, QRST. P wave represents what? This P wave represents what? This is a P wave. No? So answer number, option number A, they are asking that. Okay, this is the Q. No? They are asking contraction of both the atria.
contraction of both atria. Number B, you see the initiation of ventricular contraction. Number C, you can go here. Beginning of systole. Systole number D will be the end of the systole. See, P wave is the ECG. What is ECG? Represents the graph of the normal heartbeat. Let's call it the electrocardiogram. Okay, this will represent the. Now, P wave. P wave is what? P wave. What is P wave? Now, P wave. This will represent. P wave represent the depolarization of the atria. P wave represent what? Depolarization of atria. Okay, which leads to the contraction of the both atria. Contraction of both atria. That means depolarization of P wave starts with the depolarization of the atria, right? So this will be the relaxation of the atria, that is our depolarization. So here contraction of the both the atria will take place, and after contraction we get a wave. This is called as the P wave, or the depolarization of atria. P wave is the P wave. Just I write here, no? Okay, this idea. P wave is the depolarization of atria, or contraction of both atria. Contraction of both atria, right? This is called as the P wave. So we can give here contraction of atria. Okay, right? And QRS will be depolarization of ventricle. This will be depolarization of ventricles. Okay. And depolarization of ventricles. Okay. Then our T wave represents the return of ventricle from the return of ventricle to normal state. Return of ventricle. Okay. To normal state. Return of ventricle to normal. Okay, normal state. Normal state. So here, P wave represents the depolarization of atria, or contraction of both the atria. QRS represents the depolarization of the ventricle. And T wave represents the return of the ventricle. Return of ventricle to the normal state. Okay, right? So answer will be number A, contraction of both atria. Okay.
Now the next question will go. This finished now. We'll go to the next question now. Okay. We'll go to the next question now. Okay. Okay. Good now, finished students. So we'll go to next question now. Okay. Hello. Hello, students. Have you finished?
Yes, sir.
Hello, students. Hello, have you finished?
Yes,
students.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, the most popularly, the most popularly known blood grouping, okay, is the ABO grouping, is the ABO grouping. ABO grouping. It is named. Okay. It is named ABO. It is named ABO. ABO and not ABC. And in not ABC. ABC because O in it refers to have, because O in it refers, okay, to having. Refers to having. O in it refers to having. Number A. Okay, we're gonna start from here. This question came in the AIPMT series. Number A. Go to other antigen besides A and B on RBC. Other antigen besides A and B on RBCs. Okay. RBCs. Besides A and B on RBCs. Number B now. Number B will go to this no antigen A and B on RBC. No antigen A and B on RBCs. C will be our, okay. Now, over dominance of the type on the gene for A and B type. Over dominance of the type on the gene. Of this type on the gene for A and B types. Number D. Okay, one antibody only. Okay, either NTA or NTB on the RBC. Okay. Now here the most popularly known blood grouping is the ABO grouping. It is named ABO and not ABC because O in it refers to having, O has got what? O. Actually, there's, if you go to the blood grouping AB, then AB and O, no? If you go to blood grouping AB, then AB and O. So we have seen there that blood group O, okay, blood group O does not have any antigen. Okay, blood group O, no antigen A and B on RBC. Blood group O does not have any antigen A or antigen B on the RBC. That's why it is named as ABO blood grouping. So answer will be number B. No antigen A and B on RBC. Blood group O does not have any antigen on the RBC, right? It does not have antigen A or antigen B on the RBC. That's why it is named as ABO blood grouping. Okay. Not ABC blood grouping. It's a very simple question now. Okay. Now, one more question we can go to. Okay. All right, man. Okay. All right now. So we go to next question now here. Okay. This question is there. Okay. Which of the following statement is true about lymph? It's true about the lymph. Okay. Now, which of the? Okay. Number E, we can say that. Okay, WBC and serum. WBC and serum. Number B now. Okay, B will be our. Okay, will be WBC and serum. B will be all components of the blood except RBC and some protein. All components of blood. Except RBC.
No, all components of the blood. All components of blood. No, of blood. All components of blood, except RBC. Except RBC,
And this except the RBC and some proteins, protein number C, it is the RBC, WBC and plasma, RBC, WBC and plasma. Number D is this, okay, D will be our RBCs, proteins and plasma. Okay, now here they say that which of the following statement is true about the lymph? Okay, so lymph contain what? Lymph contain WBC and serum. Serum is the blood plasma from which the fibrinogen is removed. That is called as the serum, no? Plasma minus fibrinogen. Fibrinogen is called as serum. Okay. This is called as serum. Plasma minus fibrinogen is called as serum. So now you get that. All components of the blood except RBC and some of the proteins. So the lymph contains all the components of the blood, except it does not have the RBC. That blood cells
and some of the proteins are absent in them, and it is called the lymph. So we can go to number B, answer number B. RBC is not there. RBC is also not there. That's why we cancel these two. Okay. WBC and serum, and serum is absent there. Serum is not there. Okay. WBC is there, but serum is not there. So we take all components of blood except RBC and some proteins. Okay. So now we go to next question. Now this finish. Okay, students. Okay, then now we go to okay. After that, we go to next question now. The correct sequence. The correct sequence. To which the pulse making impulse. To which the pulse making impulse travel. Pulse making impulse travel in the heart. Okay. In the heart is number A. Go to number A now. Number A we can go to AB bundle. AB bundle, okay. Then we go to bundle of his. Arrow mark we can give here. Bundle of his, okay. HIS, bundle of his, AB bundle and bundle of his. Then we can go to SA node. SA node, arrow mark there. Okay, then the Purkinje fiber. Purkinje fiber. Then we give the arrow mark there. Purkinje fiber, arrow mark. Okay. And heart muscles. Heart muscles. Okay. Heart muscles. Number B now. B, we will go to AV node, SA node. Arrow mark, AB node, SA node, Purkinje fiber, arrow mark, bundle of his, and heart muscles. Okay, then number C we'll go to SA node, arrow mark there. SA node, arrow mark there, AV node, arrow mark there. Okay, then the bundle of his, arrow mark there. Okay, Purkinje fiber, arrow mark there, heart muscles. Okay, then B will be none of the above. Okay, B will be none of the above. Forget. I just made over. Okay. So now these are the five questions are there.
So now here, if you try to go the pacemaker of the heart, okay, if you go to the pacemaker, this the question, have you finished, student? Have you finished the question? Hello, student, have you finished the question?
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now we will have this one market to explain that here. Now, here, if you draw the heart, okay. If you draw the heart here, okay. Is the heart here now? Okay. Okay, so here this is the right auricle, left auricle, right ventricle. Okay. So now here there is a tissue here, the right auricle, this is called as the SA node. SA node, okay. SA node. SA means the sinoauricular node, okay. Sinoauricular node. This SA node is called as the pacemaker. It's called as the pacemaker of heart, because heartbeat starts from here, from this tissue. This SA node is a special tissue, sinoauricular node, and the heartbeat, generation of the heartbeat wave will start from here. Okay, and this will go to here AV node. Now this area is called as the AV node. AV node is our atrioventricular node. Atrioventricular node. AV node is what? AV node is the atrioventricular node. Then we have a muscle fiber here. These muscle fiber are called as the bundle of His. It's called as bundle of His. That's a yes. Bundle of His. Okay. Bundle of His. H-I-S, no? Bundle of his, H-I-S, his bundle of his, okay. Bundle of his, this bundle of his, and these fibers going like this, okay, these are called as the Purkinje fiber, okay, these are called as the, these fibers are called as the, this is Purkinje fibers. These are called the Purkinje fibers. So now the waves will start from SA node. It goes from SA node into AV node. Then from AV node, it goes into the bundle of His. And from bundle of His, it goes into the Purkinje fibers. Okay. So in this way, waves of the heartbeat will move. Waves of the heartbeat start from SA node. SA node is called as the natural pacemaker of the heart. From SA node, it goes into AV node. From AV node, it goes into the bundle of His. From the bundle of His, it goes into the Purkinje fiber. In this way, it will travel, right? So now we can give the answer number C now. SA node, it goes into AV node. From AV node, it goes into bundle of His. And from the bundle of His, it goes into Purkinje fiber, then heart muscle. So answer number C is the correct answer, right? Answer number C is the correct answer. Okay. So now next question, we write down there. Okay. Now, we go to One more question from the lymph. Okay, one more question.
Okay, one question, let me write and I'll ask you the question. Just now we have done. So I'm going to ask the answer from you, this question. Okay, so now we're going to ask this answer.
No. Okay.
Question is there. Pacemaker of heart. Pacemaker of heart is
okay. This question came in AIPMT four times.
This question came four times in AIPMT
exam before. So
pacemaker of the heart is number A.
Okay. AV node.
Number B, our bundle of his. Bundle of his.
Then C will be our SA node. SA node. And the number D will be our, okay, D will be
Purkinje fiber. Purkinje fiber.
Right?
So here, this is the AV node, bundle of his, SA node, and Purkinje fiber. Can you tell me the answer, students? Which is called as the pacemaker of heart? Just now we have done in the previous question, no? So which one is called as the pacemaker of the heart? Yes, students? Hello, students? Hello? Which is called as the pacemaker of the heart? SA node, yeah. SA node is called as the pacemaker of the heart. Answer will be SA node. Okay, right. So now next question will go to this. Okay. Now,
okay, now this next question will be okay.
A person
with blood group A. Very simple question.
A person with the blood group A requires blood.
Okay, the blood group which can be given is,
okay, the blood group which can be given is
number A and B,
number B,
A and AB, number C now, A and O, and number D will be AB and O.
So a person with blood group A requires blood. So the blood group which can be given is
A and O, because O is the universal donor. It does not have any antigen, and the blood group A has antigen B, not antigen A. So it has got antigen. So we can supply the blood group A and blood group O to the person with the blood group A. Okay, so answer will be number C. Okay, then one more question to go. Okay. Now. Okay. And now next question will go. This finish now? Finish all of you? Okay, this finish?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay, then we here. Okay.
Now, pulmonary artery. pulmonary artery okay is different from pulmonary vein is different from pulmonary vein different from pulmonary vein pulmonary artery different from pulmonary vein because it has now number A okay larger lumen number A it has the larger lumen number B we can say that thick muscular walls number C it has got the okay thick muscular wall then it has got the okay endothelium is the inner layer of tissue is called endothelium number D it has got the valves okay valves. So pulmonary artery if you look at the pulmonary artery will supply blood to the lungs okay pulmonary artery this is the pulmonary artery supply blood to the lungs and the pulmonary vein supply blood into the left auricle okay so this the pulmonary artery has to pump the blood okay it has to take the blood from the right ventricle and from the right ventricle blood will be pumped here and it goes into the pulmonary artery that's why to withstand the high pressure of the blood wall of the pulmonary artery is very thick the wall of the pulmonary artery is very thick in order to withstand the high pressure of the blood and the answer will be thick muscular wall answer will be our thick muscular wall okay thick muscular wall okay next question after that we go to now okay all right so next question we'll go to okay okay what is the okay which of the following no sorry which of the following is a granulocyte which of the following is a granulocyte okay a granulocyte they don't have any granules okay number A will be our basophil B will be our okay neutrophil basophils neutrophils C will be our eosinophils and the D it will be our okay B will be our lymphocytes so last time we have done in class 11 book the WBC is divided into two types granulocytes and agranulocytes granulocytes are neutrophil basophil and eosinophil and our okay this agranulocytes are the lymphocytes does not contain granules okay they does not contain granules okay that's why they are agranulocytes agranulocytes are two types lymphocytes okay and also we have the mononuclear. Okay, these are the granulocytes are the lymphocytes. Lymphocytes and also monocytes. These two are the agranulocytes. They do not contain granules in the cytoplasm. That's why they are called as the agranulocytes. Okay, agranulocytes. So answer will be lymphocytes. Lymphocytes and the monocytes are agranulocytes. And our basophil, eosinophil, neutrophil, all these are granulocytes, right? All these are granulocytes. Okay, so now, then we go to one more question now. Okay, one more question right here. Okay, now, okay, the question will be here. Now, what is the correct What is correct regarding leukocytes? What is correct regarding leukocytes? So this question came, you see, one time, two times in the exam. Okay, number one, number A, these are enucleate. And sudden. Okay, these are produced in thymus. These are produced in thymus. Number C. We can say that. Okay. These can squeeze out through the capillary walls. This can squeeze out through capillary wall. Capillary wall. Okay. Walls. And then none of the above. Okay. So now here we can see that the leukocytes at the time of the blood clotting, they come out, squeeze out of the capillary, and they produce the enzymes, fibrinogen. So now answer will be these can squeeze out through the capillary walls. Okay, these can squeeze out through the capillary walls. Okay, one more question. We'll go to last question now. Okay. Go to the last question. Okay, so the lifespan of human WBC is approximately number A. Okay, less than 10 days. Number B, it will be between 20 to 30 days. 30 days, okay. C, it is between 2 to 3 months. Okay, number D, it is more than 4 months. So now the WBC will fight the infection against the disease. They also produce antibodies. So whenever the WBC, whenever they are produced, they have a lifespan less than 10 days. After 10 days, they are destroyed.
and another WBC is formed. Okay. Now, and after that, we go to one more question now. Maybe last question. Okay. All right. Now, is finished, all of you? You student, have you finished this? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. Now, go to. Okay. Okay, now here each of the following is placed. Drop off each of the following. Each of the following is placed. Is placed on separate. Separate slides. Oh, slides, you know, slides are the glass. Piece of glass is called the slide. So, separate slides. Okay, slides. Which of them will not coagulate? Separate slides mean on the four slides. Okay, then they say that which of them will not coagulate? Which of them will not coagulate? Which of them will not coagulate? Okay, number A will be serum albumin. A will be serum albumin. Number B, it will be the serum globulin. Serum albumin, then we can go to. Okay. Just you can write here, just cut it here. You can write here blood serum is better. Blood serum. Okay. Blood serum. Okay. Then we have blood plasma. Blood plasma. And C will be a sample from thoracic duct of the body system. Samples from thoracic duct. Thoracic. Sample from thoracic duct of lymphatic system. Then number D. We have whole blood from pulmonary vein. Whole blood from pulmonary vein. Okay. Now here, if you take the samples, four samples we have taken, blood sample. First, we take the blood serum. Okay, here we take the our number A. Number A will be blood serum we take. Then we take number B here, slide number B, the blood plasma we take. Slide number C, we take our sample from the thoracic duct of lymphatic system. All these samples we take, C. And then we take number D. Your whole blood from the pulmonary vein. Okay, so now here, which one will not clot? See, all of them contain blood clotting factor, blood plasma, sample from thoracic duct, whole blood from the, all of them contain RBC, WBC, and also the blood platelets, except the serum. I told you, serum does not contain anything. It does not contain any blood clotting factor. It does not contain RBC, does not contain WBC, that's why it will not clot. So our answer number will be, answer will be blood serum. Okay, blood serum, we can write there. It does not contain RBC, WBC and clotting factor. Does not contain RBC, WBC and clotting factors, right? So that's why the blood serum will not clot. Okay. So now here, okay. Which way? We'll go to the last question today. The last question we'll go today now. Okay. Now, okay. Now, continuous bleeding. Continuous bleeding. Okay. From an injured part. Okay. Of the body is due to deficiency of number A, vitamin E, number B, okay, vitamin B, vitamin K, and number D, vitamin E, right? Okay. Okay, so answer will be our vitamin K, because we can say that vitamin K, okay, vitamin K is required for clotting. Vitamin K is required for clotting. Okay, is required for clotting and vitamin K. Okay. And required for clotting. Vitamin K is required for the formation of the prothrombin in liver. Okay. Vitamin A is required for formation of for or formation of formation of prothrombin. Prothrombin in liver. And prothrombin will change into thrombin, no? Prothrombin will change into thrombin. So the deficiency of the vitamin K will cause the bleeding disorder. So we will stop here today, or one more question can we do? So student, now one more question we'll do. Okay. All right. So one more question we'll do, students. Last question. Okay. Last question we'll do. Okay. You can go to this. Okay. Okay, now erythroblastosis coitalis occur in the child. Okay, when
Rh positive mother and Rh negative child. Okay, second one is Rh negative mother and Rh positive child. And Rh positive mother and Rh positive child. Okay, number four, Rh negative mother and Rh negative child. Okay, which one is correct? Please find it out. You find it out, please, here. So answer will be Rh negative mother and Rh positive child, because mother will produce antibodies and blood will produce antibodies, and there will be no coagulation of blood. That is why, and the RBC of the child will be destroyed. That is called the erythroblastosis fetalis. In the fetus or embryo, blood will be RBC will be destroyed due to mismatching of the blood, because mother is Rh negative antigen, mother have the Rh negative antigen and the child has got Rh positive antigen. So when the RBC of the embryo will be destroyed, RBC of the child will be destroyed, this disease is called erythroblastosis foetalis. Okay. And one more we write here. One more question we write here. Okay. Finish this one, student. Have you finished this one? Students, have you finished?
Breakdown product of hemoglobin. Breakdown product of hemoglobin is number A, bilirubin. Okay, bilirubin. Number B, okay, iron. C will be our biliverdin. Okay, it will be calcium. And okay, D will be none of them. So here, you see that when the RBC are older, then hemoglobin of the RBC here, hemoglobin will be destroyed by liver. And hemoglobin will destroy it and it will change into bilirubin. Okay. So answer will be our bilirubin. So today's class, we will stop the class today here. And next time we will we'll do the question from the respiration chapter. Right? All of you?
Okay.
So thank you very much. We stop the